Welcome back to Echo. We've just passed through another of these large doors. We're moving into the land of the Iron Maiden things. I think that's what they're called. These little torture devices.
This place is horrible. How could anyone enjoy themselves surrounded by man cages?
Oh, they definitely just saw me. Don't want to miss any of the tuning forks. I saw something over here, getting highlighted. I really didn't? Oh, over that way, further away. Gotcha. Oh, they're trying to actually get me from the back. Oh, if they get me from the back, I can't resist it. Try number two. Oh, they saw me. Oh, Jesus. Another tuning fork over this way. Oh, I'm seeing a bunch of things light up over here. I think I just saw two. Oh god, they have a gun. If they shoot, does that attract other people here? It does. Oh, thank God. That was very good timing. Okay, so one over to my left. One over to my left. Was it this one right here in the middle of the room? Damn it. Oh, probably this one. I'm kind of exposed. Crap. Ooh. Oh. That was almost disastrous. So where am I going? I guess somewhere over here. Okay, whew. I love the flow of this game, it's so good. See, these little pillars are not very good to hide behind, they're just a bit too small. So something I could try is maybe...
Over here.
Did anybody hear that? No. I'll try to shout.
Hey!
Uh-oh. No, 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 no! Oh god. Fuck! Fuck! God, a scream is blood-curdling. Oh, damn. Okay, I think I'm roughly back to where I was before. I think I got all the tuning forks again. And I think we're supposed to go over here. Yeah, it looks like that's leading to the point. Waypoint. Oh, another airlock. Okay, hold on. I think there's a spot over here that might lead somewhere interesting. Yeah, what's down here? This long hallway. Yeah, there's another tuning fork. I just saw it. Well, not necessarily a tuning fork. It could be something else. Compiling. What? Did one of them hit one of the tuning forks? Is that what happened? I think one of them hit a tuning fork. Yeah. Someone just hit it again. I see you sneaking over there. So one right there. Is that it? Let's wait for it to come back. Someone's still banging him. That same one just got pulsed. Yeah, just that one. I think I've actually been here before in my last attempt. Ah, yeah, so it's not a tuning fork, it's... one of those energy things. Oh. There's one over there, too. That might have been the one that they just already hit, but I don't want to count on that. You sneaky little me. That's a tough spot. I need to do takedowns. Yeah, that one just got ring. I think we're good. I think we got it. Let's try that. See, that one's gonna see me because it's looking the wrong direction. Yeah, I'm gonna say I think we have the other one because they seem to keep ringing it, so. Okay, we're fine. We're fine. So oppressively dark down here.
I can feel a strange pulsing from those cylinders through the suit. It feels like a really loud bass.
It's not sonic. The field print tells me they're hyperconductors. The force applied to sustain them ripples the suit somehow.
Veins flowing with answers.
Come again.
These are what's making it all possible. To keep sync on a planetary scale. Every few minutes, every blueprint is maintained meticulously. Imagine if the palace was populated. The chaos of input, analysis, and reaction.
All that wasted on some sick game.
A game that will bring Foster back. I just need to beat it.
We've seen nothing here that proves Foster can come back. On the contrary, the echoes aren't you, N. Just like recreating Foster will not be Foster. He's dead.
But he's not. That's what I keep saying. He didn't die. He was translated.
To you, it's so fresh in memory your adrenaline is pumping. But in reality, he died more than a century ago. You hope to bring him back. It's just crazy.
It can be done. Grant's explained it to me, but I doubt you'll understand.
Try me.
The apparatus translated Foster into a Kaya supersymmetrical manifold. The corresponding neutral field was captured in solid form, the cube. He really is in there, still alive, and the palace will remanifest him.
That is just ridiculous. The manifold is a theoretical shortcut. Not even during the push was it pursued to that end.
My guess is it was. When else would this place be thought up? I figure some rich house considered this their retirement plan as the requisition jitters started to gain momentum.
You just speak whatever comes to your mind. How do the echoes fit into this nursing home theory of yours?
For one who's seen it all, you really are very narrow-minded. Reality is diverse. And the push era was notoriously considered the era of splintered humanity. Spreading through the universe brought about extreme human constellations.
Don't you try giving me history lessons.
I'm just saying that the wealth needed to develop tech like this, the ability to keep it secret, their grotesque imagining of paradise, it all matches a recluse house. The echoes were probably entertainment to them, seeing the lower castes fighting to survive. The creators expected to be gods here and designed everything to constantly remind them that they were.
And the resourceful spend their lives preparing for the challenge of being gods?
I suspect Gramps' ticket here wasn't first class. More like gatecrashing. That would mean fighting to gain privilege and access. Constant betterment. That's what Gramps prepared us for. And that's exactly what's needed to finish this.
So the game. Ben thinks the game is just for the pleasure of the... I forgot what the other group of people was called. And that we're gatecrashers, basically. Trying to win the game that, I guess, is not even really supposed to be winnable. But again, it's definitely malfunctioning. So how is it different from what it's supposed to be? Is it just those anomalies we see? Is that it, or is there more that's wrong? Yep, so those are full charges. Something far below me just pinged. New types of flowers. Yeah, this looks like a dining hall. I see like all sorts of cutlery and things on the tables. So we've got, once again, two things on two sides, so probably two of those staffs that I need to get to open a main door. That? Oh, is that a... Oh, that's mostly not flowers in the center. I think that's actually food. It's like a cornucopia, sort of. Although none of it looks prepared. Like prepared food in any way. It just looks like all fresh fruit. I keep forgetting the doors do that. It scares the crap out of me. Looks like that goes down. So that's one of the ways down. Oh, I think I have to go down to get to that waypoint, huh? Let's look more around the outskirts, though. This one also goes down. Hope there's nobody on it. Good. Oh. Savey thing disappears when the power goes out. Looks like we got maybe half, maybe a little bit more than half. Let's go down. Dang, that was pretty slick. I impressed myself there. Oh, someone's coming. So here's the doorway. Oh god, there's three of them right there. Alright, let's just jump down and go get this one. Just got spotted. Let's see if I can get away. Yes. Oh, they might be able to jump over, actually. Okay. It's possible they actually can jump over and they're just not doing it because they aren't thinking to look down here. So I'm not taking that as definitive that they can't jump. I saw a ping over in that direction. Oh, there's another one too. Oh, bunch of them. Now they can definitely jump over things. Just saw it. Whoa. When you force a blackout, does that force a reset? Is that what just happened? Yeah, this thing is back too. That's good to know. I did not realize that. Look for pings. Nothing. Okay. So how do I get up there? Stairs. Oh, there's a safe thing over there too. Perfect. All right, let's grab this and save. Before the power goes out. There we go. All right, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'll get the other staff and open the door.